Hey everyone, Mr. Sugiano here. In today's video, we're taking a look at the Moza Nano SE, a smartphone gimbal and selfie stick combo. Let's get started. Alright, to kick things off, Moza sent me this Nano SE to take a look at and check out. In a nutshell, it's a selfie stick with the built-in stabilizer, and it also has a detachable Bluetooth remote. It comes in two different colors, black and green, and they sent me the black one. Opening up the box, there's the instruction manual, the gimbal, and a USB-C cable. The instruction manual is pretty simple, but it tells you everything you need to know. The USB-C cable is fairly short, but you really don't need a long one here. This gimbal is a lot lighter and a lot more compact than I thought it was going to be. I'm actually pretty impressed with it. The detachable remote is hidden on the inside of the gimbal. The remote is pretty tiny and light, but it doesn't feel that cheap. It's used to control the gimbal as well as your smartphone if you pair it to it via Bluetooth. If you're worried about losing the remote, you can just leave it mounted into the gimbal. Setting up this Nano SE is pretty simple and straightforward. You open it up, you put your phone in, you power it on, and you're pretty much good to go. I have a Samsung Galaxy Note 9, which is not a small or a light phone, and this gimbal handles it absolutely fine, which is a very huge plus. I've tried out some other gimbals and they don't support this phone's weight. Fortunately, the Nano SE does. The remote can also change this gimbal from landscape to portrait mode and back again with the press of a button. The selfie stick portion of this gimbal extends roughly 27 inches, so just over 2 feet. When it's fully extended, you can also adjust the position of your phone, which is a huge plus. Fully extended, this does not feel flimsy, and the gimbal does a pretty good job at keeping the phone level, and raising this in the air pretty high up at an awkward level, and it remains fairly stable. The base of the Nano SE features a built-in tripod. Not gonna lie here, I was a little bit nervous about testing this one out. I'm testing it out on pavement, and if this tips over, my phone is pretty much toast. It was a little bit wobbly fully extended, and I wouldn't recommend tilting your phone at all, but it did remain fairly stable, and that's a huge plus. On top of that, the remote works to change the orientation of your phone from landscape to portrait if you want, and it can also control the camera from a distance. The remote worked from about 8 feet away. When I got further away from that, it wasn't as responsive. So here's the gimbal fully extended in selfie mode, and if you take a look at the video, it's remaining fairly stable, even when I raise the gimbal above my head. This is a huge plus. On other selfie sticks, things get pretty shaky as the camera flops around on the top of it. This gimbal is pretty solid and doing a pretty good job at keeping everything relatively level. The Nano SE is compatible with the Moza Genie app on Android and on iOS. Now, I don't use this app because I don't need to. It's completely optional. And to be honest, I'm not the biggest fan of the app, but it is there if you want to use it. Now, in terms of price, the Nano SE is $45, which is inexpensive for a gimbal, but expensive for a selfie stick. It's in a very weird place. I brought up a comparable selfie stick right here that sells for $22.09, and it's very close to the Nano SE, except this selfie stick does not have a built-in gimbal, but it also extends a little bit further. This one goes to 40 inches instead of 27 on the Nano, so an extra 13. With that being said, do I think this is worth $45? And I will say yes. There are a couple of things I don't like. The Nano SE isn't perfect. I'm not the biggest fan of the tripod. It was a little wobbly to my liking. And on top of that, it didn't work the best in the cold. I found that after a while, this was not as responsive as I wanted it to be in cold temperatures. I live in Canada. We're dealing with a lot of cold temperatures right now, and this thing did not like the cold at all, but inside it worked absolutely fine. And now moving on to what I did like about this. First and foremost, this supported my Galaxy Note 9, which is a huge plus. Not all gimbals out there can support heavy phones, and I didn't think this was going to be able to do it. But it did it, and that's pretty awesome. The video stabilization on this was a lot better than I thought it was going to be, given its price point. On top of that, it doesn't feel cheap. It's light, it's compact, but at the same time, it seems pretty well built. If you're looking for a relatively inexpensive gimbal or a selfie stick that can take stable video, this might be a product for you. Now, if you don't need the selfie stick portion of this device, but you're looking for the ultimate in video stabilization for your phone, you could check out something like the Moza Mini MX. It's a little bit more expensive, but you get a lot for what you pay for. I did a review on this a little while back. I'll leave a link in the description if you want to check it out. But anyways, that is all I've got for today. Let me know your thoughts on the Moza Nano SE in the comments below. If you like this video, leave a like. If you didn't like this video, leave a like, hit that subscribe button, check out my other videos. Thank you, everyone. Take care.